Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video we will learn about the phasors and the phasor diagram. So in a very simple way, if I say this phasor is nothing but a simple way of representing this sinusoidal signal. So now when we have more than one such sinusoidal signals which is having a same frequency but different phase and different amplitude, then we can use this phasor diagram to represent the phase difference between these sinusoidal signals. So now we know that any sinusoidal signal in a general form can be expressed by this expression, that is Vm into sin omega t plus 5, where Vm is the peak amplitude of this sinusoidal signal. Omega represents the angular frequency and the 5 represents the initial phase of this sinusoidal signal. So now let us represent this sinusoidal signal using this phasor. So now this phasor is nothing but a vector which rotates around its origin at a constant speed of omega radian per second in a anti-clockwise direction, and here the length of this vector represents the maximum amplitude of this sinusoidal signal, and its angular velocity represents the angular frequency of this sinusoidal signal. So now if we take the projection of this rotating vector on the y-axis, then we will get the instantaneous value of this sinusoidal signal. So now as you can see here, as the vector rotates in an anti-clockwise direction at a speed of omega radian per second, and if we take the projection of this vector on the y-axis, then we will get the instantaneous value of this sinusoidal signal. And if we plot all the values which is possible for this phasor, then we can reproduce this sinusoidal signal. So now let us see how we can represent this phasor on a phasor diagram. So now on this phasor diagram, different AC sinusoidal signals which is having a same frequency but different amplitude and different phase are represented. So while representing these phasors on this phasor diagram, we only represent them by their amplitude and the initial phase. So let us say we have a two sinusoidal signals. The first is, let's say, 5 sin omega t plus 30 degree, and the second signal is v2 is equal to 10 sin omega t plus 80 degree, and we want to represent these two signals in terms of the phasors in a phasor diagram. So the first signal is 5 sin omega t plus 30. So first we will draw the vector which is having an amplitude of 5, and it will make an angle of 30 degree with the horizontal axis or a reference axis. Now if you see the second signal, that is a 10 sin omega t plus 80 degree. So here the peak amplitude of this signal is 10. So we will draw a vector which is having a magnitude of 10, and it will make an angle of 80 degree with the horizontal axis. Now sometimes this phasor is also represented by the RMS value of the sinusoidal signal. The reason is that the most of the measurement which is being carried out by the ammeter and the voltmeter are in terms of the RMS values. So sometimes you will find that these phasors are represented by the RMS values instead of the peak value. But in this video, we will consider the peak values of these sinusoidal signals. So now let us see one more example based on this phasor diagram representation. So let us say now we have a voltage that is equal to 10 sin omega t minus 30 degree, and the second voltage or second signal is 5 sin omega t minus 120 degree. And we want to represent those signals on this phasor diagram. So the first signal is 10 sin omega t minus 30 degree. So we will draw a vector which is having a amplitude of 10, and it will make a angle of minus 30 degree with the horizontal axis. Now second, we will draw the second signal which is having a amplitude of 5, and it will make a angle of 120 degree with this horizontal axis. So we can draw a vector of a 5 amplitude and having a phase shift of 120 degree. So this will be the representation of V2, and this will be the representation of V1. Now on this phasor diagram, this anti-clockwise direction is known as the leading direction, and this clockwise direction is known as the lagging direction. So as you can see here, this V1 is leading the V2 by 120 minus 30, that is by 90 degree. So here this V1 signal is leading the V2 by a 90 degree. Similarly, in the first case, if you see, this V2 signal is leading the V1 signal by 80 minus 30, that is by 50 degree. So now so far we have seen that how to represent the phasor on a phasor diagram. Now let us see how we can represent this phasor in a mathematical form. So the first form is the polar form, where we can represent this phasor in terms of r and theta. So suppose we have a phasor which is having an amplitude of Vm and it makes an angle of phi with the horizontal axis, then in the polar form we can represent it as Vm and phi. So the next form is the rectangular form. So in this form we can represent any phasor by a complex number, that is a plus jb. So the amplitude of this phasor will be under root a square plus b square, and the phase of this phasor can be given by the expression tan inverse b by a. So this will be the rectangular form of representation of this phasor. Now the third form of representation is the exponential form, where we can represent the phasor in terms of Vm into e to the power of j phi. So these are the basic three representations by which we can represent this phasor. So now as we have seen how to represent any phasor in a phasor diagram as well as by a mathematical expression, now let us see the phasor relationship between the voltage and current for the basic circuit elements like resistor, capacitor and the inductor. So first we will see that the phasor relationship between the voltage and current for the resistor. Now let us say we have applied this sinusoidal input to this resistor. So this voltage signal can be represented in a phasor form as Vm into 5, where Vm is the peak amplitude and phi is the initial phase, or simply we can say that this is nothing but capital V. Now according to the Ohm's law, the current IT that is flowing through this resistor will be Vm into sin omega t plus 5 divided by R. And if we write this equation in terms of the phasor form, then we can write it as a I that is equal to capital V divided by R, where here I and V both are in the phasor form. That means V is nothing but Vm over 5. So now as you can see here, the both voltage and current are in a phase. So if we represent this voltage and current on a phasor diagram, then it will look like this. So as you can see here, both voltage and current are in a phase. Now here, the ratio of this voltage over current is also known as the impedance. So for the purely resistive circuit, the impedance is equal to the resistance. Similarly, now let us see the phasor relationship between the voltage and current in the case of inductor. So now let us here assume that the current that is flowing through this inductor is given by this expression, that is Im sin omega t plus 5, or in terms of the phasor relationship, we can write it as a Im into 5, or simply capital I. Now we know that the inductor voltage can be given by the expression L into di by dt, or we can write it as a omega L into Im into cos of omega t plus 5, or we can write it as a omega L into Im into sin of omega t plus 5 plus 90 degree. So this will be the expression of a voltage across the inductor. So as you can see here, this voltage leads the current by a 90 degree. So in terms of the phasor relationship, if we see, then the phasor diagram will look like this. So here is the current that is flowing through this inductor, and the voltage will lead the current by a 90 degree. Now suppose if we represent this signal in terms of the phasor, then we can write it as a omega L into e to the power of j pi by 2 into Im into phi. And we know that e to the power j pi by 2 is nothing but a j. So we can write it as a j into omega L into just capital I, where capital I is nothing but a Im into 5. So this will be the expression for the voltage across the inductor in terms of the phasor form. So now we know that the ratio of voltage over current is nothing but the impedance. So here we have seen that this voltage can be given by the expression J into omega L into I. And here both capital V and capital I are the voltage and current across this inductor in terms of the phasor form. So we will get the impedance Z as J into omega L. So we can say that for the purely inductive circuit, the impedance or simply a reactance of this inductor will be J into omega L. So now similarly, let us see the phasor relationship for the case of a capacitor. So here let us once again assume that the capacitor voltage that is applied to this capacitor is Vm into sin omega t plus 5. And we know that the capacitor current IC can be given by the expression C into dV by dt. That is C into omega into Vm cos of omega t plus 5. That is nothing but omega C into Vm into sine of omega t plus 5 plus 90 degree. So this will be the expression for the current that is flowing through this capacitor. And as you can see here, the capacitor current leads the voltage signal by a 90 degree. So in terms of the phasor representation, if you see, it will look like this. So if this phasor represents the voltage, then the current will lead the voltage by a 90 degree. Now suppose if we represent this signal in terms of the phasor form, then we can write it as a capital I that is equal to omega C into e to the power of j pi by 2 into Vm into 5. Or we can say that j into omega C into capital V, where capital V is nothing but Vm into 5. So this expression is nothing but the current that is flowing through this capacitor in a phasor form. And as we have seen earlier, the ratio of voltage over current is nothing but the impedance. And here, as you can see, it is nothing but 1 over j into omega C. So we can say that for the purely capacitive circuit, the impedance or simply a reactance of the circuit will be 1 over j omega C. So in a summary, we can say that for the resistive circuit, the current and voltage will be in a phase, while in case of a purely inductive circuit, the voltage will lead the current by a 90 degree. And in case of a purely capacitive circuit, the current will lead the voltage by a 90 degree. So now suppose if we want to remember this voltage and current relationship across this resistor, capacitor and inductor, then we can remember this just by using this simple keyword, that is a civil. Now if you see this word, if you see the first three letters, that is C, I and V. So we can say that in capacitor, the current leads the voltage by a 90 degree. And if you see the last three words, that is V, I and L, then we can say that in inductor, the voltage leads the current by a 90 degree. So in this way, we can remember that in case of capacitor, the current leads the voltage, and in case of an inductor, the voltage leads the current by a 90 degree. So now in the next video, we will see that how to draw the phasor diagram for the RL, RC as well as the RLC circuit. And we will also solve some problems related to these phasors. So I hope in this video you understood about the phasors and the phasor diagram and how to draw the phasor diagram for the basic circuit components like resistor, capacitor and the inductor. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.